Today we celebrate the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please make sure your cell phone is in the silent or off mode. Please stand as we begin our celebration of the Eucharist and join with us in singing your entrance piece, number 634. Come ye thankful people, come. Number 634.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God, glory to God in on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God. Glory to God in on earth. Peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God. Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God in the highest. glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God. Glory to God in all earth. Peace to people of
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess or are counted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and you to the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a of the desert it flows. The hills are girded with joy. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. The meadows clothed with flocks, the valleys are decked with wheat. They shout for joy, yes, they sing. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down, and the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once, because the soil was not deep, and when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed
fell on rich soil and produced fruit 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The disciples approached him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, and hear but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear but not understand. You shall indeed look but never see.' Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their hearts and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Hear then the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it, and the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy, but he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100 or 60 or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you.
First of all, a line from St. Teresa of Avila. She said something like this: "In light of heaven, the worst suffering on earth will be seen to be no more serious than one night in an inconvenient hotel." Or it's sometimes put this way: from heaven, even the most miserable life, the life of the most suffering, will look like one bad night in an inconvenient hotel, or we might say a seedy hotel. It's what came to my mind when I heard or read the first line of today's second reading. "Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us." I find those lines so consoling. "Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us." You know, these quotes put suffering in perspective. The Lord wants us to see our suffering in this life from the perspective of eternity. Whether it's physical suffering, mental or emotional suffering, or the suffering we may experience from watching the suffering of a loved one, the suffering that we experience, or like the consequences that come from the result of our sin, the suffering we experience as a result of the ills of society, all the violence, the darkness, the evil in the world, or whether it's the suffering of persecution, whatever the suffering, in light of eternity, it is temporary. Nothing, Paul says, compared with the glory to be revealed for us, like a bad night in a seedy hotel. Now, despite this consolation regarding suffering, there are still questions that arise in our hearts. Why does God even allow suffering? Why do some experience more suffering than others? And the list could go on. I'd like to share with you some words of Pope Benedict that I came across this past week that I found very helpful in this regard. And he continues with some of the questions. Is God really fair with his gifts? Why does he give one person so much and another so little? Why is everything made so difficult for one person and everything pretty well heaped up for another? He goes on, this is Pope Benedict, if we burrow into questions like these, we do not get any closer to the truth. God's ways are so far above our ways. But he ended by saying this, we have to learn, like the saints learned, that God's grace is often dark, but that it is precisely in suffering that grace lies. God's grace is often dark, but it is precisely in suffering that grace lies. Very similar to what he said in his encyclical letter, God is Love. This is again Pope Benedict. I've often found these words very helpful. It says, often we cannot understand God's ways. Yet he does not prevent us from crying out, like Jesus on the cross, my God, why have you forsaken me? He says, our crying out is, as it was for Jesus on the cross, the deepest way of affirming our faith. Our crying out is the deepest way of affirming our faith. He ends by saying, even in their bewilderment, Christians continue to believe that God is our Father and loves us, even when his silence remains incomprehensible. I also like what St. Catherine of Siena said to those who rebelled against what happens to them. She said this, everything comes from love. All is ordained for our salvation. God does nothing without this goal in mind. Everything comes from love. All is ordained for our salvation. God does nothing without this goal in mind. So suffering is difficult and often incomprehensible. And we may be tempted to abandon our faith, rebel against God. But the Lord is always calling us to a deeper trust that whatever he allows in this life, no matter how great the suffering may be, is ultimately for our salvation. That and the fact that our suffering is limited, temporary, can perhaps make it that much more bearable. That's why that first line in our second reading today is so important. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. In other words, he wants us to always keep our eyes on the goal. Just think for a moment, though. You know, our sufferings can be very great in this life. And Paul says those are nothing compared to the glory. So can you imagine the greatness of the glory that awaits us? How great the glory will be. As the scriptures say, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has it so much as dawned on man what God has prepared for those who love him. Yes, it's beyond our imagination. And yet we get glimpses. We know that we shall see God face to face. And in that gaze, we will know a love beyond all telling. We'll know a peace, a joy, a bliss beyond imagining. We'll take our breath away. That's what we need to keep in mind in the midst of suffering. As St. Gregory the Great, my last quote today, as St. Gregory the Great urges us, he says, let us stir up our hearts, rekindle our faith, and long eagerly for what heaven has in store for us. To love thus is to be already on our way. No matter what obstacles we may encounter, we must not allow them to turn us aside from the joy of that heavenly feast. Anyone who is determined to reach his destination is not deterred by the roughness of the road that leads to it. Anyone who is determined to reach his destination is not deterred by the roughness of the road that leads to it. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. The Eucharist that we are about to receive is a foretaste of that glory. And it, the Eucharist, will give us the strength to bear whatever crosses the Lord is calling us to bear. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With faith and confidence, let us place our needs and petitions before our loving Father.
For the church, may God give us the grace to sow seeds of goodness and tend the soil of the earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders in government, may God grant them hearts of understanding and conversion to the gospel of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For farmers and all who work to grow and produce the food we eat, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community gathered here, May God open our eyes and ears so we can hear his voice in all we do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the call to serve Christ and his church in the priesthood and consecrated life will fall on the rich soil of hearts prepared by prayer, hard work, and generous service to others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may God welcome them to eternal rest in heaven. And for Marcia Coles, who recently passed, and for Carmen Bueno, whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, trusting in your goodness and your mercy, we place these needs before you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Our preparation hymn is number 493, Change Our Hearts, number 493.
Change our hearts, this Lord. The Lord says it can be changed.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, to the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you, in thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of a reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not at our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace be with you always. Let's offer to the sign of peace. Behold, Lamb of God, Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
While we share the Eucharist, sing with us number 910, Shepherd of Souls, number 910.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This coming Saturday at 8 a.m., weather permitting, we're going to paint the retaining wall around the church. So if anyone would like to help, I have a sign-up sheet for volunteers in the back exit of the church. Again, that's this coming Saturday at 8 a.m., weather permitting. And you can put your name and your phone number there in case if this weather prevents us, we'll give you a call. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our concluding hymn is number 803, For the Healing of the Nations, number 803.
Shots.